Hello and welcome to Enquire to Choir. My name is Eva and I'm here to help you, fellow choir people. As you know, because you came to this video, there are people in the world who can't read music. And we love them just as much we love those who can. At least, that is true for me. In amateur choirs and non-professional choirs, there are a lot of choir members who can sing beautifully but can't read music. They deserve our undivided attention. So here is my contribution on the topic. First of all, I just want to say, don't underestimate them, don't make them, and don't let them feel less capable. Just because they don't know how to read music doesn't mean they are not wonderful singers. They just didn't have the circumstances in their younger life to learn music, to be introduced to music. Personally, I feel I'm privileged because my desire for music was backed up by my mother. I'm grateful for it and I don't take it for granted. Not all of the people were so lucky. Keep that in mind. My first tip is give them a lesson or a few. I really don't understand why people don't do this more often. Just set the time to give a lesson about music, how to read it. You don't have to explain the whole system. You don't have to teach them the whole system. But just the basics is good enough. They don't even need to learn where in the score is the exact note by name. If they pass the audition for the choir, they probably have an understanding for which tone is higher, which tone is lower. So if you explain to them how in the music sheet they can recognize if the tone is higher or lower than the previous one, that's already a huge step. Additionally, you can explain to them which lines or which rows are actually theirs to read, because that's not a given knowledge, you know. Plus, teach them the basic terms for dynamics: piano, forte, crescendo, decrescendo. That's already a huge thing to know. My next tip is record them the lines they have to sing, or let them record the rehearsal. Listen, you want to give it your all. You want to see there has been improvement from one rehearsal to the next. What I do is I record myself singing the lines they have to learn. We read them during the rehearsal, but then I record them and let them have the recordings and listen to it. It's very important just that the first information is on the rehearsal, not that they get the recordings first. The first information should be from the conductor, and then they get the recordings to repeat that said information. I'm aware that maybe you're working on an enormous music score, so you can't possibly record every line because it's too time consuming, but you can let them record the rehearsal for their own use. We are all trying to do our best for the benefit of the choir, so I don't think there's something wrong, very wrong, with thinking this way. Tip number three, yes, they have to have their music scores all the time. Just because someone doesn't know how to read music doesn't mean it's not useful for them to have the music scores or music sheet in front of them. There are a lot of information in those papers. Let them study it. It's a huge amount of time they have to spend with it, and after a while the brain will become accustomed to the font, to say. Plus, make them grow a habit of writing things down. I let my choir members draw on music scores if they want, because drawing makes them understand the melody more or remember it better. And finally, I just want to say, I've discovered people who were not musically trained can sometimes become even better musicians than the ones who are. They're more open-minded and they were not under the structure which the music system education provides. Sometimes that can be a problem, yes, I know, but mostly it's a wonderful thing working with someone who really appreciates music as it is. Short and sweet and hopefully helpful. Any other tips? Comment down below. Thank you so much for watching and for being here. Conduct well, conductors, and I'll see you next time. Bye!